part of the cloud ERP full stack solution. Webinar will be hosted by me, Gert-Jan ter Weeme, and Ralf Hartendorp. Ralf will do the actual demo part of this webinar. Short agenda, introduction, more in general, what is cloud ERP based on Salesforce Financial Force. Then the CPQ part on the Salesforce Financial Force. Then we will end with the demonstration. And we have some time reserved for questions and answers. All right, as a short introduction. So for the people who don't know Financial Force, it's created in 2009, has now over 1,000 customers globally, headquartered in San Francisco. And for us in Europe, having a big headquarter in the UK. Best thing of Financial Force is that it's 100% natively built on the Salesforce platform, so integrates seamlessly with the Salesforce environment. And how it is positioned is the full cloud ERP solution. So where your sales or your services or your marketing part from Salesforce will stop, then Financial Force starts. From financial management, let's say accounting, down to your professional services and human resource management, your inventory control to end up with. So the full stack ERP. Financial Force itself is a Salesforce IFC partner with over 660 employees and still rapidly growing. So it's one of the main players in this area. If you would summarize it, it's around professional service automation, financial management, and human resource management as the main domains. But the supply chain management part is also predominantly in the background there as a solution as well. Okay, well, who is Cloud Team? We founded ourselves in 2014. Now, grown up to 18 experts with offices in the UK and the Netherlands, and we have an Apex development center in Belarus and a financial services center in Pakistan. The clients that we serve are also organized around the globe. So although we are not that big with 18 people, we do fly across the globe from Africa to South America, which makes it for everybody quite an adventure. But that means that we can really serve our customers in this way globally. Our services comprise, let's say, cloud ERP strategy and digital transformations, like we do for Philips as a big company, for instance. We do the implementations of PSA, HR, supply chain management, and the financial management. For Financial Force itself, we are one of their preferred implementation partners in Europe. And we have the ability, with our technical setup as well, to do app development and enhancements on the platform. Just an overview of the experts that we have, with the momentum that we gained with multiple clients now, we're even more rapidly growing. So we have a team of experts, as mentioned earlier, and with that we have done, let's say, multiple variances of implementations, sometimes starting off with one module like FFA. Sometimes we were asked to do the full stack implementation ranging from FFA to HCM to PSA to CRM and supply chain management as well. But most of the clients normally start off with, let's say, a certain area, PSA, and then more from a roadmap perspective, they move on. Like we stated, we also do develop apps, which are then, let's say, true enhancements for the platform in Europe. A bank integration, SEPA bank integration is one of the examples, but also our payable invoice scan app, which makes it far more efficient to process thousands of your incoming payable invoices. So if we talk about cloud ERP, like mentioned before, it's really being able to provide the full process in your company, ranging from your initial sales to your project delivery, your resource management, resource allocation, and down to your billing and revenue recognition. Now, this makes it unique as one solution coming out of the cloud integrated with Salesforce as such as well. It's really recognized as one of the most powerful solutions currently. If we then take, let's say, one short zoom in on the CPQ part. The benefits of CPQ for business, what we see also with our clients, they grow rapidly. So with their product and services to offer, it becomes increasingly difficult to manage that product pricing. Also to identify, let's say, your great upsell opportunities and keep track of your deals and being offered by your competition. Now, on top of this one, sales reps aren't given up-to-date pricing information. Maybe you recognize it as well, leading to, let's say, a loss in opportunities or a slower responsiveness to present quotes to the markets. Also, the configuring part with this huge list of products and services can also be very time-consuming, slowing down you as a company as well. Now, with CPQ software, it eliminates these problems. It can really identify, quickly upsell opportunities, bundle them, and have you the ability to send those out quickly. And also, because the pricing data is more streamlined, internal organization will also become far more effective using CPQ. All right. So if we look at the elements of CPQ and as part of the module in the full ERP solution, you could say it's about guiding your selling and make sure that the right products or combination of products and services are chosen with the right associated, let's say, pricing, making sure that you have your best offers for your customer to go out. Okay, now, like we said, so CPQ is then part, let's say, of your end-to-end solution, so being part of your full cloud ERP possibility. I will present just a couple of slides to give this overview, so how it could work in practice. Now, starting off with your sales quote, so your sales reps have been working on an opportunity down to the moment where you really want to send out your proposal with the accurate and on-the-spot quotations for your clients, right? So your starting point of kind of closing and trying to close the deal with your prospect. Now, if the process starts from here, and let's say in the happy flow, and the opportunity is won, the big value and the benefit of this cloud ERP solution is that your opportunity, with also the milestones included, can then automatically be transferred into a project. And in the project created, the milestones from your opportunity will also be recognized and automatically be generated. So the handover from sales, let's say, to your organization that will start executing the project is far more easy. And like we said, so then you are moving into your project setup. So based on all the opportunities that you won and the project that you've started, you will have the opportunity to create your full project management dashboard, looking at the progress and the success. In each individual project, having the ability to work with a full interactive Gantt chart, making it possible to really manage your complex projects out of the same platform. Obviously, tracking your financials, so your revenue against your margin and your cost, how is it all evolving? For the people who actually work on your project, the ability for them to record their time against the right assignments and the right tasks set, making it manageable for customers to run with a small, let's say, back office setup, an enormous amount of people actually delivering your projects. And for those people working on those projects, it's not only about time writing, but obviously also about their whole expense management. Some of those expenses can be billed out to your clients. Some are simply internal costs, but you want to track this as one single entity at the end, to be sure and to be able to see your project margin made at the end. And from your project, like I said, with the milestones automatically being infused in your project, you can start billing out on milestone level or simply on time and material basis or a combination of, again, out of the same system. So it's very easy to see if also invoice-wise you are on track towards your client. Generate your invoice. So by email, it will go out. And at the end, with, let's say, all the invoices sent out, you also have your overview on your customer. What about the days outstanding of those invoices sent out? So what is the overall financial status of these clients? Maybe in combination of some projects, maybe in combination with subscriptions they also have. So it's at the end, the story is that with the cloud ERP solution, you have the ability to create this 360 view of all your customers. From your opportunity down to project, down to, let's say, revenue recognition and days outstanding on your client. Back to CPQ, this webinar all about. I hope I gave now, let's say, the insight how it links back to the overall process and the overall cloud ERP possibility. Ralph will now take over and give a short demonstration how this could look like in practice. I'll stop sharing. Ralph, you can take over from here, right?
Yeah, I'm sharing right now.
Okay, good.
So thanks for this first introduction of the model. I'm actually, as you mentioned, CPQ, and you showed the integration from CPQ to projects. I'm also touching another point from CPQ, and this is the CPQ part, or actually from the opportunity to projects. I will now touch the opportunity to CPQ, and also use another CPQ that we have presented before. So in June, we created a webinar around the Salesforce CPQ, formerly known as Steelbrick. There are other CPQ systems on the market like Velocity or CloudSense on the Salesforce platform. But there's also another, maybe not that known CPQ, which is from FinancialForce themselves. And I'm starting to use it this time because I think it is nice advantages that could work for different type of industries. So let's say we are starting to work on an opportunity, and this opportunity I've just created is a kind of opportunity where there are products and services part of the opportunity. So actually I created the opportunity on the account Prestige Worldwide, the customer that we are selling to, and the customer wants to buy some bikes for a specific Salesforce event that they are promoting. So they want to hand out bikes, and they also include some service on those bikes. So what I did is I create the opportunity. It's at the moment at the value proposition. And on this opportunity, I added some products. So this is all the standard features of FinancialForce. So I'm just waiting for my program to start, because it doesn't seem to be able to click on the products view. What's happening? Yeah, now it's the hyperlink is working again. So I created some products. I add those products based on the price books. So this is all standard Salesforce CRM. The only interesting thing of this CPQ demo, actually, it's linking to FinancialForce CPQ, which actually gives some more information to the products. For example, this classic bike that I'm trying to sell. So I've got a picture here, which doesn't really seem as a classic bike, but this is what it's part of the setup. It's configurable. It has a kind of possibilities that could be sold across item options. So whether you include standard features or you want to create some additional options. And based on the integration with the supply chain module, you can already enter all kind of criteria to help you to speed up reordering and or either manufacture or assembly yourself this type of item. So this is a bit of the integration from CPQ, including logistics. So from this opportunity, we created some of those, this opportunity for the classic bike. We want to create a quotation. Now, I already created the quotation to prepare a bit our demo. So normally what you will do is just click and create the customer quote. As I already created, there's just now a hyperlink to directly zoom into the customer quotation. As you can see, the system starts with some in bold some pricing at the moment, some profit related information about the cost and the total customer price. It gives me the information of the customer quotation details that has been taken over from the opportunity, including some default information. For example, if it needs to be a kind of a drop shipment of the goods directly to the customer. But then actually it's becoming interesting at the quote lines. So whether you use Steelbrick or Salesforce CPQ or Velocity, the idea around the CPQ is that you will be able to configure your products based on upsell or items options that you can sell directly together with the main item. So Financial Force did make it in a way that you can link to the classic buy a kind of an option list. So if I expand the options, you can see that I actually have selected 30 bikes for this event, but I will also be able now to, let's say, configure those bikes based on my discussion with my customer in order what are his needs and what type of options I can sell directly together with this bike. So at the moment, there are some standard brakes, forks, and wheels being selected. They will be able to also unselect them and change, for example, the comfort seat instead of the normal seat, or to add, let's say, a teen speed gear to the bike. So all these kind of things joined together will be prepared on your item master, on your product lines, or in your CPQ setup. Then things like grouping them is standard of Salesforce. Also how to actually then start negotiating, for example, the margin. So if you are in negotiations with your sales team, you can, for example, have different type of actions to influence the margin or the sales price. For example, if I want to change the profit margin, and the profit margin at the moment, as you can see, is the item cost is 125, the list price is 250, which means actually a profit margin of 50%. So that's not really that rocket science. If I, for example, need to decrease my price and I think, well, still with a 35%, profit margin, I will be able to have still a good deal. I can select the line that I want to apply the profit margin. And if I just press apply button, we'll be able to see that things will be start to change. And now my list price has been decreased from 250 to 192. And this is actually a pricing percentage that probably is still something that's acceptable for my manager. If I would, let's say, try to work to force this price to our internal organizations to get approval. So this pricing has got all the information, even if I want to see what if it's linked to suppliers, a kind of the internal pricing. And here I see the total pricing of my whole deal. And everything is then updated on the quote breakdown. So this is very quickly the a kind of a view of how CPQ could work in an environment with Financial Force and supply chain. Now this pricing, especially with Financial Force, that's the advantage to see also if you're selling products, how you can source those products. So with the source requirements, if I hit this button, it gives me directly an insight information about, okay, we've got these bikes, it compares of items and of the full system. Are they available? How do I need to do the sourcing? So if I retrieve the sourcing, I will be able to see, for example, on the classic bike, that at the moment there was nothing on stock, but actually there are still a few of those bikes, 50, being on a purchase order. So this purchase order is being set out to Sabre Electric. I can directly zoom into this purchase order, just open a new screen. And the purchase order will give me the details, for example, when those bikes will be delivered. What is the shipment day? So this bike has come some purchase order lines. And in this purchase order line, the supplier committed actually to a date on the 6th of November. This PO will be delivered. So this is with the way that Financial Force has the integration directly with purchasing and purchase orders, which is, I think, a big advantage depending on the type of products that you are sourcing. But this is a bit of a step towards the sourcing part. Of course, we have the printing part, or creating, let's say, prints that you can send out as a quote directly to your customer, to your prospects, where also your prospect has insight directly about other options that they, if they still consider probably to change from the standard to an additional kind of luxury model, they can still apply for that and send their information or the comments back to your sales rep. So just to go back to the opportunity, because from, let's say that this opportunity after you have submitted for approval can be sent out to the customer, and the customer will accept actually this this opportunity, this quotation. So the stage will be changed from value proposition to closed one. So we'll save this. Now, what's happened in the background is that based on the automation that we can prepare for you, is that a billing contract will be created, because this opportunity, which has products but also has services, we set actually the services to be invoiced on an annual basis, just to be to show you again what we have how I've set it up. The service is based on an annual service. I'll try to, I don't know why the hyperlink on my view all doesn't work again, but it's creating a contract. So this billing contract will then be the contract that we will invoice out the products at a one-time basis and the services on an annual fee basis. So this is the contract being set up, linked to the opportunity name, linked to the account, have a start date and an end date. So the contract runs for 2 years, and these 2 years will be specifically be important for the service that will be sold together with the bikes. But the service is a recurring billing type. It's fixed, which means that the price won't change based on volume or usage. It's just a fixed amount of 30 times the fee rate, which is in the end, it's an annual fee of 120 per year, and a one-time fee for the 250 of the bikes. So in the end, as you can see, probably calculate that the amount of service is the same actually in 2 years as the amount of the classic bike in the end. So it's quite interesting that the service portion is really valid for your revenue. Now, once you create this billing contract, it can automatically be activated and create billing schedules. Billing schedules will be your definition, what type of invoice will be sent out at which moment. So if this is a one-time and an annual, which means that the start date is the 1st of November, then we can also set, okay, what will be our first bill date? And actually it's the same date as the start date of the contract. So it means that the billing schedules are being created, so we can directly create the first billing document. This is also something that can be started already in the background automatically, but just to show you the steps is I will just create just this first billing document. As you can see, the billing document is being created, and this billing document is actually the first draft invoice that can be sent out if, for example, if you first want to approve all the invoices that will be sent out to your customer. So this billing document contains then the first invoice in this type. So you can see that this is including the classic bike and including the service, but the service only for the first year. So if I will just, for example, make an example of this, of a printed version, this is actually how it should look like. So the service of 30 times 120 and the classic bikes 30 times 250. There's no text yet in this module because we haven't linked directly the text to the company, to this billing document. It will be created anyway when we create the sales invoice. So based on the default information of Financial Force, it then will be directly linked to a company, and this company has some text settings. So those text settings will determine what type of text will be charged based on the location of the customer. Is it international? Is it export? Is it within the EU? Is it in this situation within the USA? Which probably creates a very complex tax and sales tax, like tax one, tax two, tax three, because you have state, county tax, and city tax. Now you can see that there's a kind of an invoice setup again. Again, we can now view the PDF, including now the tax calculations. And the next step actually will be to post this sales invoice. So the transaction into our financial system will also be completed. Of course, those steps can be automated if the whole process is that configured that there's no need to intervene by any person or doesn't need to be any approval. Then these kind of steps will be able to all do them together, including the posting. While the system is busy in loading the invoice layout, I also will post this sales invoice, so we'll be able to see the finance transactions into our accounting books. So here's the invoice, including again the information showing actually that it's a contractual information with a service for the first month, and also including the tax total and the breakdown of the different tax information. On the other side, the invoice bill is posted, including now a finance transaction. So if I click on the transaction, I can see the transaction lines. I just view them all. I will be able to see the full general ledger journal with the accounts receivable amount, so the invoice that's been sent out, the amount of revenue based on the product sales, and the amount of revenue based on the services. Now, as you can see that these, and it's a bit of strange information about goods received, not yet invoiced, but this is actually the service amount, which is still on the balance sheet item, because the service itself will be invoiced based on the recognized revenue information. So actually, the next step and the final step, which you can be done every day or on a monthly basis, is then to recognize the revenue of all the products or services that will be invoiced based on installments that are not directly related to periods in your financial books. So in this case, you can see that the recognized revenue module has got all kind of objects where it can determine what revenue needs to be recognized based on each object. So it could be a project for your time and material or your fixed price project. It could be a service contract. In this situation, it is just a normal contract. And this contract, if I want to run, for example, the revenue recognition for the first month, so for the first month of November, because we started actually the invoicing at the 1st of November. So let's see what kind of revenue will be need to be recognized for just 1 month. As the information of this, the invoice has been created. At the moment, you can see that we started with the contract 53. So this was actually contract 53, the Salesforce event classic buy promotion. So it's picking up this element. And as you can see, it's created one line for the service information. So it's not using any of the product information of the sales bikes, because the bikes are just a one-off sale. So they were just invoiced at the first of the month, directly being recognized for the full amount. But as the service is a kind of an annual subscription fee, of 2 years, which means 3,600 per year. In the end, it's for a total year of 7,200. It can only be recognized for the first month, which is actually 300. So here you can see that we will, by this system, we can select, on this situation, I'm only selecting this contract, and I will just leave the other contracts as they are. And I can submit this record. So the system will create the revenue recognition journal into my finance books. In the end, to have the correct value of the revenue on the subscription, also compared to the sales invoice that has sent out already the full year of revenue. So in this by this demo, I just showed you in a very quick view all the steps from the opportunity. So where we have created the opportunity, and it started actually with linking the two products, and those products, especially if I use the service product line, it has the elements, which is really interesting, that on the contract line, I can show you in the, and where it is, this is just the service product. And I'm just trying to find out where I have put in the forecast template. It's not here. It's probably on the contract itself. So if I'm opening the contract line, and I'm just back into the contract line. So on the product service, and it's just coming back with the service line contract or the product line contract, the line of the service in the contract line will determine the type of revenue recognition. So it's actually an equal split. The whole amount of the contract will be split equally across all periods. So there are several ways of revenue recognition with Boldy. If you need to dive in, you will see that all kind of combinations will be possible, but things like subscription billing will normally be split on the equal split across the periods. So here we will determine on this contract line, which how the revenue recognition needs to be executed from the system. So again, starting from the opportunity, showing the opportunity where we already make a start of the products. On those products, we can already, and the opportunity, we can already determine the contract start and end date. So this will all be taken over to the contract. On the products itself, there will be information which will be taken over to the contract, the type of the billing, the one-off or the recurring fixed, at what time we will start actually the billing. So this is always the start of the month. And that information is all being gathered at one time to be used directly in the contract. But first, before you can create a contract, I did show you a quick glance of the financial for CPQ. So the quotations that have been created based on the system. So this quotation will have its own approval phase, its own, let's say, ordering phase, if you need to order those bikes with the supplier. And in the end, if the customer quotation will be accepted, you can also have an option to create a sales order from the opportunity. And that sales order will be, let's say, order the billing contract will be used to be signed by your customer. So from this quotation, it will update the opportunity to be, let's say, closed one, if once the quotation has been signed. And from this closed one opportunity, the contract is created. And the contract will be the basis for sending out the invoices to your customers. And once you've sent out the invoices, or even if before you send out the invoice, you can already recognize the revenue based on the active contracts. So once a contract is active, it means that for the system, it is actually the basis to perform the revenue recognition transactions. Okay, well, I think for me, that is in a nutshell, the information I want to show you as an addition to the introduction that Gert-Jan gave us for the for this kind of webinar content. Just want to open at the moment the moment for any questions. So I don't know if there are any questions about this demo that you've seen so far.
Yeah, you can type it in the chat box, otherwise, or indeed just unmute. That's also possible. Or raise your hand.
Yeah, I have a quick question.
Yes.
Do you know the billing part? Is that Billing Central?
Yeah, this is Billing Central, Irfan. So the billing contract, creating billing documents, and from billing documents create sales invoices is the Billing Central module from Financial Force.
And revenue recognition, is that part of Billing Central as well, or is that completely separate?
It is positioned as a separate module. So it's not always the situation that you, if you're using the contract billing module, that you also need to recognize revenue. So they separated it into another module, which is can be purchased together along with projects or with Billing Central, but you can also exclude it from your financial force modules.
And you know the CPQ part you showed, is that pretty new? Because I haven't seen that before, which is this something that they've worked on recently? Or
No, the CPQ is already there for years, within the supply chain module. Yeah, we implemented it at one of our clients in the Netherlands, and they are using it together with the service contracts within the SCM module, as the Billing Central was not available at that moment. Yeah. Any other questions? Okay.
Yeah, if not, then we will make sure that, that everybody who joined this webinar, you will receive the recording out of this one. And that also gives you always the opportunity to reply and ask additional questions if required. And otherwise, you can always reach out to us requesting, let's say, a face-to-face session to explain more in detail. So many ways to keep in touch.
Mm-hmm. Okay, thank you all for participating to this webinar, and looking forward to see you on the next webinar that we will launch within a few weeks or months. Thank you.
Yes. All right. Thank you very much. Bye-bye.